Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Force of Nature. We're off camera. I've done a little bit of gathering and preparing. We may, in fact, have enough water now to make some more coffee. As you can see, I've been stockpiling the coffee supplies because we are going to be doing a lot of work out and about in the wilderness in this particular episode. As you can see down here, I've managed to stockpile quite a number of our building resources because I would very, very much like to make some progress on building a second well in this particular episode. We're going to go ahead and we're going to make some copper ingots. That'll be wonderful. 3 copper ingots is 2 of the copper ingots that we need to build our compass, and one that we can possibly use for nails, which would be good, because finally we'll be able to make George a proper pen. That is right, our goat is named George because goat starts with G and George starts with G as well. Okay, there isn't a complex naming structure here, okay? I just like alliteration, okay? Right, now, for our compass, we are going to need 2 tin, we've already got that, 2 copper, we've already got that, 2 gold, we're very far away from that, and 4 glass, we're reasonably far away from that, though we've got enough sand to make it. It is going to be a little bit of a pot because it does take so much coal to make each piece of glass. I'm probably going to have to gather more sand before then, to be perfectly honest with you. But we can go about making some fangs. Now, to make the fangs, the ash. We need 5 ash per portal, and that is one of our quests at the moment, is to make 2 portals, and the last quest, and this is what I'm going to wrap the mini-series up with, the first day series, is once we get a Force of Nature shard. That's really the first step towards the mid-game sort of stuff, is once you start collecting Force of Nature shards, from what I've been able to gather online. Now, we're quite a ways away from that, but with time-lapsing, a lot of what we need right now is just resources that we have to gather from outside. Now, we need a mortar for this. How does one make a mortar? One makes a mortar over in a bonfire. So let us go and see which of my bonfires are closest to being done. You are quite far away, as are you. So I'm just going to cancel. I should have waited. Did I get the sticks back, I wonder? You know what? I don't know, and I really should have been paying attention to that. Right, okay. We can get a mortar easily enough. Now then, over here. How are we doing with these copper ingots? Got all 3 done. Perfect. Let's see about the glass. Now, the glass is going to need only 5 sand. Actually, that's a lot better. It's the 10 coal, which is the problem. But we only need 4 of these, and that's just as well, because we can only make 4 of them. Very well. And I would like 1 set of nails. What I really need is 2 sets of nails. You know what? Fine. We're going to turn all of my copper into nails, because I'm bound to get enough copper when I have to go out and get the bajillions of claws that I'm going to need to make the ash that I'm going to require for the portals. I'm going to be slaying so many goblins, it's just going to be silly. So we're going to go ahead and make all of this so that I can get a second well, because honestly I feel that is significantly more important to me right now. As for the glowing embers, I would like to continue making them, so crack on and have fun. Right, over here, we will be building the second well just by there, and at that point, we'll have a pretty good little system going, I feel. Let's make sure to replant all of our coffee, because we're going to want a fair amount of health-restoring and stamina-restoring items, because as we've noticed in the past, when you run out of stamina, you can't hit things, and it's very, very hard to not die when things are hitting you and you can't hit them back. We'll grab that. I would like to make some bread if I am able. Let's see. Can I access this there? Yes, I can. And here we go. Take all that. Can I make some bread? Oh, I need the eggs as well. My bad. Let's grab those then. There we go. And here we are. Some bread, if you would be so kind to, will do. Let's drop these off there. Right. Now, with regards to the claws, the thing with this is the crafting table can only hold 3 individual tools. So I guess I'm going to have to swap these out as and when. For now, though, let's just make the ash. I've got enough to make 2 pieces of ash. We're very far from being able to build our portals. Each one requires 5, so we have got a lot of stuff we need to do. An awful lot of stuff. Let's pop that in there for now. and go and check on our nails. There we are. We'll take all 30 nails. And how's the glass going? The glass isn't actually going too bad. Okay. Now, I believe, if we're very lucky, I will have already prepared everything. Yes, we have. Hurrah! Let's get this down there. I cannot wait. I could rotate it around just for aesthetics, but I'd actually prefer it like that. There we go. And now I guess we could also go ahead and add in the fences here as well. Let's select this and see if... Boom, and boom. There we go, George. You have your pen. It is glorious, and you are welcome. Drop off those 7 nails, and in fact, the coins, because we don't want to lose those coins should we die. On that same note, I should probably drop off a lot of stuff that I'm just carrying around. Am I going to? No. No, I'm not, because I'm silly. There we go. I'm just going to grab that water. I really hope that there is some later structure which allows gathering water a little bit easier. Some sort of water well or something like that would be pretty cool. There you go. You can have that. Can I also get my rooster? Yes, fantastic. Because we are going to go through our arrows fairly quickly, I should imagine. Okay, I think we're more or less done here then for the most part. I'll take this. Let's see, have we finished that? Yes, we have. Glorious. Now, what we need for the compass is... Ooh, that's a little bit of a pain. How much do we need to make a chest? We need 15 nails. Unfortunate. Let's see, are there any other storage devices? I don't think there are. We're going to have to save up quite a lot of copper to get those nails, or just find a load of iron out and about. But we need, ultimately, 4 glass, 2 tin, 2 copper, and 2 gold. And that's all going to take a fair old bit of work for us to get, unfortunately. But with that, have I got enough coffee on me? Coffee beans? I've got enough for 3. Sure, let's go ahead. Collect the bread and set 3 more cups of coffee to be made. There we go. Perfect. Right, on that note, we're going to be heading out. We need to get an awful lot of things. The main thing that we're looking for is going to be claws and fangs, but also copper coins and, of course, gold coins. So, oh, wow, really 2 roosters? Somewhat tempted. Tiny little bit tempted, I think. But I don't think we will, ultimately. But, you know, there was definitely a little part of me there that wouldn't have minded that. 3 gold coins in 1 go, that's actually pretty good. But, no, I think our 1 rooster is more than enough. So, I'm going to time-lapse the combat, and I will see you back when we have a load of stuff that I desperately, desperately need. No, no, don't surround you scallywags, you! There we go. And with that, we are heading home. I have exhausted almost all of my resources in this run. I am quite low on stamina. In fact, I'm going to drink a cup of coffee, even though we're heading home, just in case I end up in an attack situation, because I need stamina to fight. But I have gone through almost all of my health-giving items, and that is actually quite impressive, considering how many I started this trip with. It has been about 35 minutes. That's about 30 minutes of time that I'm going to be compressing. I may drop a cut in. I'm probably going to do those all one big time lapse, though. So I would appreciate your input on that one, because I'm probably going to have to time lapse it a little bit. I mean, it's going to be fairly heavily compressed, but it'll probably be like a minute and a half time lapse. Let me know if the longer time lapses are actually fun to watch or not. Come on in, yeah. There we go. We have now got Carolyn the cow, who is going to be hanging out with George the goat. Fantastic, if you ask me. Also, my inventory is so full of random stuff. Well, actually, not random at all, really, when I think about it. Okay, well, now I need to find a place for all of this general gubbins. But one thing that I would very much like to do is get our blast furnace working. So, come on then. What are we going to do? We've got enough gold to make the two gold ingots that we need. Fantastic. There we are. Let's go with that then. And I'll store the rest of the gold. Oh, it is good to be back. There were several times out there that I thought we might not actually make it back. It was touch and go for a few moments there. Right, I want a ridiculous amount of ash. So go ahead and make me all the ash, actually. Well, we don't need quite that much. We'll have eight. Eight bits of ash, and that'll leave us with nine claws that we can pop somewhere else, I guess. We are going to need two copper, two gold, and we should be good with that. Also got some honey. Ah, the bears, though, they are what you need to be attacking. I know that sounds silly, but it's true. The bears are by far the better things to be going for in terms of getting all of the claws and fangs that you're going to need. It was significantly faster once I started just hunting bears. Right, I would like to take all of the water. Let's get ourselves a fair bit of coffee going. Now, interestingly, the coffee was the one that I didn't use as much. I think, really, I need to be focusing on the health regenerative items for a little while. Maybe even swapping out all my coffee seed beds for strawberries, in fact, because as you can see, I went through all my apples, all my bread. I didn't have that much bread. I was holding that generally for emergency situations, but yeah, quite a lot of things were used up regardless. So go ahead, make me 20 there, and make me 20 in here as well, if you'd be so kind. Oh, well, 15 will do, I suppose. Right, all of the gold, there we are. Now, next up, I would like a redonkulous amount of copper, actually. Let's see if we can make that a reality. So, copper from coins. I can make one. Why is this? Lack of glowing embers. Well, it just so happens that I should be able to pick up quite a few of them over here, so that'll do. Thank you. Alright, I'm still not going to be able to make that many, unfortunately, because at this point, then, I lack the coal. Always something. Basically, but with those two copper ingots, I'm going to be able to make our compass, and that is a big step in the right direction. Yeah, I guess I'll just wait for that to all be finished there. Let's pop the copper in here. That clears up my inventory a tiny wee bit. Not that much, really, but, you know. The palm leaf. Honestly, I can just drop this palm leaf because it's... Oh, no, I'll keep hold of it until I need it for something. Do I have any water on me? I do not. You know what, then? We're going to go and gather some water so we can give Caroline some water and some wheat so she can start producing us some milk. Now, I believe that the cows produce a lot more milk than the goats. Let me just have a quick look. 4 and 1 versus 6 and 2, but I'm fairly certain that, yeah, we get twice as much milk for 1.5 times the wheat with the cow. Though you do still use twice as much water, but water is by far the easier thing to come by, so it's not really that big of a deal. I'm going to need a lot more eggs. So the chickens are the ones that are going to be fed at this point. Here you go. All I'll take that. And I guess I could get the looser to make me some more feathers as well. Ah, this is fantastic. I'm actually doing stuff with all of my animals. This feels amazing. Have I got any milk on me? I do not. Also, how much flour? I've got quite a lot of flour, actually. And I've also got a reasonable amount of milk in there, too. But let's go ahead and make a bunch of bread, because we need to replenish the bread supplies a wee bit, I think. I like the water to make any more, that's fine. Right, let's have a look. We should have some. Oh, no, don't attack my buildings. What a derp. Right, and there we go. We've got enough now to make our compass, which should... I think the ash is more or less done as well. Well, actually, no. The ash is going to take a little while. But that's fine, because I want to build up a couple of my resources anyway, I guess. And we've got a little bit of time there. So I'm going to drop a cut here, and I'll bring you back when we are ready to build our compass. And there we are. Our crafting table has finally finished the ash. Now, at this point, we need our screwdriver to replace the mortar and pestle that we've been using to grind up all of the ash. And we can pop that back in there. And we can at last make... not make a screwdriver. A compass. Oh, I need the tin ingots as well from in here. There we go. Alright, here we go. Now, how long is this going to take? It is going to take 3 minutes and 20 seconds. That is rather excessive, in my humble opinion, but it does give us time to go around and do some other things. Okay, so we've got loads of bread being made, coal being made all over the place. Oh, well, actually, in just 2 very specific places, but it is good. There we are. We are also making plenty of iron. We're actually up to 4 iron ingots at this point, which I'm incredibly pleased with, I must confess. And we will have the last bit of our iron ore turned into an ingot as well. That frees up a little bit more room in our inventory. And over here, we are slowly making progress towards our compass. It takes 3 minutes and 20 seconds to get that, which is far, far more time than I would really like to spend getting it, but okay. Now then, what we can do is build our very first portal. So let's have a quick glance at this. We've actually got all of the necessary requirements to build the 2 that we need. Now, this is actually not that big of a thing, which I'm fairly pleased with. Let's see. Would we be able to place it down here, perhaps? So it would be more or less just outside of the hut? I think so, and I kind of like this placement. It doesn't quite fit in with everything, but we'll pop it there. So there we go. The last one, this has also made us a new iron ingot. And thanks to George and Caroline, we have a fair bit of milk on us right now. And it looks like we had a little bit of a hiccup there. I may have lost a little bit of footage. I'm not entirely sure. A bit of a hard drive space issue. But as you can see, and as you may have seen me doing, I'm not sure how much of the original video I'll be able to keep. But we have now built... Oh, perhaps you can hear it more than see it. The portal, the first of the 2 that we need to build, and it's humming there, kind of ominously. And we are in the process of building our compass, and there it is, we finally have our compass. And oh, well, that's pretty cool. It's actually on my... Oh, that's... Is, really? Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah, it rotates with me. Now, hopefully, we can use this to find ourselves... Oh, there it is. There's the force shard. It is pointing towards the force shard right now by the looks of it. And yes, it is pointing straight to the force shard. Okay. Now then, from what I understand, building this second portal will allow us to instantly teleport around. Though I think you can bind the portals. Alpha Centauri? No. No, I refuse. This is not going to be called Alpha Centauri. This is going to be called... let's see. Aavak Prime, I think. There we go. Alright. Start the game from this spot from now on. That is actually quite useful. Alright. Now then, with all of the odds and sods that we've got, I think it may, in fact, be time for us to head out. And possibly have a bit of a scuffle with some scallywags. Maybe, possibly. I'm not entirely sure on that. Having 2 wells is so good. Oh, my lord. Right, let's see. Have I got enough eggs to make... I've got enough to make another... 1 bread, I think. Yeah, it requires 2 flour. So you know what? Instead of that, let's make a load of flour. Let's go ahead and make, 20 flour. That'll give us enough for 10 new loaves. Well, 11 if you include the flour we've already got. Though what it won't give us is enough eggs for that. So we're going to need to make sure that our chickens are constantly producing eggs. But on that note, let's go and see what we can find out and about in the darkness. Let us hope that it isn't anything too terribly violent, though I've got a sneaking suspicion it is actually going to be something terribly violent, yes. You know what? Since we're going out at night, let's make a... I think we're going to use some of the milk that we've got to make butter. And with the butter, we are then going to make ourselves a... little lamp. So let's get you making some more milk. Same with you. Now that bread, unfortunately, is going to take an age. I probably should have thought of that first. Well, here's for sciencing. Will I get all the wheat back? Yes, yes, I do. Okay, well that is pretty good then. Let's go ahead and make ourselves 3 butters. I need to check what is involved in making a little lamp. I can't make it here, so it's probably made on the craft table. Have a look. A pocket lamp. I can make 10 pocket lamps with 1 stick of butter, 5 clay, and some glowing embers. Okay, now, a lot of people in the comments have said that the lamps do not get attacked like the torch posts do. Which, if you ask me, is a pretty good thing. Especially since we get 10 of them per stick of butter. That is actually a really good return. Caroline has prepared some more milk. Wonderful. That thrumming is a... I don't know, it feels like an inner ear massage. Though I imagine there are some people who won't enjoy that. I know that there's sort of deep rumbly sounds occasionally. That's more of a negative for some people than a positive. But I quite like it myself. Alright, let's see. Let's go grab these milks. There's so much to do around the camp now, which is actually really nice. There's a lot of stuff for me to just do to pass time. I'm constantly moving back and forth, tending to one thing or the other, which makes it seem like when I'm just waiting on something, it isn't quite as bad as it probably really is. There we go. Let's get all that going. I've got 2 more water. I'm going to need a little bit more because I'm going to want some eggs. Let's go and get that. We'll take all of these. Thank you. I've not been making coffee for a little while. And then we will feed all of our chickens. And the pocket lamps are done. Perfect. That's all I was waiting on. Right, let us head out. In fact, I'm going to put the pocket lamps right there. Oh, apparently no, I'm not. Where do I put the pocket lamps? Maybe I just build pocket lamps? I have no idea. How does one use a pocket lamp? This is something we're going to have to find out. I feel it is super important information. I also think that I've cut a path back here, I believe. Or have I not? I have not, as it happens. Very well, let's cut a path now then. We'll have to slay some gobos on the way out, but hopefully that won't be too bad. Hello, would you like to come and play? I'd like to play. I mean, it won't be fun play for you. I'm going to be honest with you. It's going to be pretty wretched, actually. Oh, all 3? That's a little bit more than I was bargaining for, honestly. Come on, then. You coming? There we go. Let's have a proper little fight now. Oh, maybe they just don't want to come down to my camp. That would be kind of nice if they had some sort of limit on how far their aggression would go near your starting location. Because I had wondered... if the goblins would ever actually move that close to place, put it in a use cell. So it would have to be over there. But it doesn't look like I can put it in the fast action. Okay, well that's a bit of a shame. But should night fall, then I can start placing those down. And I probably should make a point of placing them down in the day right now anyway. Right, so we've got a little bit of a trek. But it shouldn't be too dangerous overall. I'm thinking we're just going to have to mow our way through several goblins and get up to where that force of nature shard rests. Hello! Let's have a little bit of a fight, shall we? There we are. Now, one thing I don't have is arrows, thinking about it. Ooh, that is possibly a bit of a silly, really. Should probably prepare... Oh, dear. Right, well, you know what? Staying in here is probably good because it limits how many of you can get at me. Hello. Come on then. Let's have a fight. You, just you and me. Thank you. Thank you very much. Because I can take you out by myself. Having two or three things attacking me, that makes it a lot harder. There we are. One there down. Come on then. No? Okay, fine. I'm going to carry on then. Anything else back here that I need to tangle with? Nothing so far. There's a bunch of iron down there that I wouldn't mind tapping into, honestly. That would be very useful for me. Now, the main thing is I just need to get more or less to where I'm meant to be. And once I'm up there, I can drop down a portal, and then I can rapidly transport between locations. If I feel I need more arrows because it's really important for me to have the ability to engage my enemies by drawing them out, then I can just go back, build some arrows, and teleport back up here. That may help. Though I'm not sure if teleporting will reset an area. In some games, any kind of area transition like that will effectively count as resetting, in much the same way that I imagine that sleeping does. It causes everything to respawn that has been killed from the world. So, you know, there may be some negatives to teleportation as well. And honestly, I would imagine there are. We need to be going in this direction, roughly. Why am I checking the map? I've got a compass. Right, okay. Where are we going? No, actually, let me just check this. I've got to find the piece of nature. And I still have to create the second of the two portals. So, that's fine for now. Oh, hello. Let's take you down then. Eat more strawberries on the way. I really should actually start planting more strawberries. I really, really should. Hopefully, all of these millions of gold coins and copper coins that I'm gathering just from fighting are actually going to help me level as well. Now, there are a couple more enemies showing on the map. That's why I was checking the map, so I could see if I was about to walk into an ambush. That's right. Of course it was. There's goblin over there. Let's take you out while I'm over here. There we go. Hello, chicken. Now, I wonder how animals and followers would react to me doing that. I'm going to have to eat some of my bread at this point, I think. Let's take you out. You're going to be an easier one to kill. And more bread, please. There we go. Not too terribly bad. I think the boar is going to get sick of fighting me before I die. Excuse me. I do apologize. I'm going to have to eat a lot more strawberries. That was a little bit risky. A little tiny bit risky. Though, the question is, if I build my portal too close to this place, is that going to cause a lot of issues for me? Are things going to randomly attack the portal? And sorry for that, I had to clear my throat. Now there's some tin up here. It seems to be a nice little glade. I'm wondering if they're free of enemy spawns. That would be super useful if they were, because I'd prop the portal just down by there in that case. Ooh, lots of enemies up around here. Okay, well, you know what? Let's try that. Let's drop our portal in this lovely little glade here, full of flowers and loveliness. And we'll pop it right about by here, I would say. Let me just harvest that out of the way. Right, I would like my second portal, please. Can I build that? Yes, I can. Right there will do. And then following that, I'm going to surround this with a couple of lamps. Pop a lamp up there. Oh, wow, that built super fast. Pop a lamp over there. Pop a lamp right there as well. Sure, I'm going to really well light this area. Mostly the surrounding area. Since the portal seems to generate a bit of light itself. There we are. I just don't want to get ambushed while I'm up here. It's my main concern. There we go. And we could just pop over here. Maybe drop one or two just along this tree line as well. Oh, I do apologize for having to clear my throat so much. Hopefully I'm managing to mute it enough, or I have had the common sense to cut that out in... Oh, I no longer have any lamps. In post-processing. But, here we go. Nice and lit. And apparently, we're right next to the shard. Though, we now need to rename this particular portal, I think. Let's go ahead. There we go. Nature's Den. And we can teleport back to Aavak's Prime at will. At this point, however, I'm liking those lamps. They actually do cast quite a nice little light. Let's go and see about getting this Force of Nature shard. How many enemies are around here? And will I be able to pull them? Two is fine for now. That'll do me. Let's see if I can't lock them in there. No, I couldn't. I was hoping that I might be able to force them to fight me around the tree, which would be a little bit better for me, because occasionally shots miss. But that's fine. I managed to take care of those two fairly easily. There are a lot of enemies here, though, and we do need to be careful of that. How many are in here? Hello. Let's take you two on, shall we? There's a bear up there that I need to be quite wary of as well. But as long as I can manage my engagements by just pulling one or two at a time, I should be okay. Especially given the amount of strawberries I've got. Let's gobble down some more of those on that matter. There's a boar over there that I would like to take out just to make things a little bit easier for me. Come hither, boar. Thank you. I really do wish I'd bought some arrows, though. That would make this significantly less dangerous than it is. Ah, the boar's scallywags. Running away! You coward! Okay, at this point, I think I'm going to gobble down one of my breads. Now, can I draw the bear? So the bear is a good one to pull out. If I can draw it. Damn it, we've also got a goblin. That's fine. Honestly, I'm going to go for the goblin first, because this goblin should go down pretty quickly. Oh, that being said, it's a runner, really. Wow, okay. They are level fours. Okay, fleeing, deciding to choose my life instead. Eat some more bread. Let's try and gather all my energy back as quickly as I can. Need to go around here. Ouch. Okay, hopefully we can teleport fairly quickly. Not sure about that. Actually, no. You know what? Let's just barrel down and hope for the best. We are close to death. I think we are going to win, though. Ha-ha! Take that! Perseverance! But we are seriously hurting. Okay, to Aavak's Prime, rather. Yeah, I wouldn't have survived, I don't think. That would have taken me too long to teleport. I'm really sorry about the flickery lights. I know, so annoying. But I think I'm going to need to build up a couple of things before we go back there. We are definitely in need of better healing materials and a lot of arrows, I would say. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly prepare all of that, and I'll bring you back when I'm ready to return and fight our enemies. Okay, then I think that's going to be about all of the buildup that we need for this next attempt on the Force of Nature shard. I have been making all kinds of restorative items. I'm going to make sure that we're producing more milk. And wow, does it take a long time. The time is not as easily noticed. I noticed it because I've got a timer that's letting me know how long I've been recording for. But to be fair to the game, I didn't notice the time pass as much because I had so much to do around the camp. But wow, things like cheese, that really does take an awfully long time to produce, because it's about 45 seconds to make a piece of butter. Then you've got to make the cheese out of butter and milk, and you've got to build up the milk supplies first. It all adds up rather quickly, actually. Right, let's go ahead and get a bunch of flour being made as well. At this point, I'm probably going to need to start worrying about my wheat stocks, but let's get back to that. It's going to be night again, but that's fine. We've got four cheeses, four breads, five strawberries. They're practically a non-issue at this point. They're scarcely worth considering, actually, as healing items compared to the amount of damage that we're starting to take. Now, have things replenished their numbers? Not really, and I specifically did not heal in the bed to try and dissuade the game from respawning anything. We've got a good number of arrows at this point, though, which I'm very, very pleased with. Okay, so we're going to try and approach this from the side and maybe draw out some of the enemies here. Now, again, there are more powerful enemies in this area, and they do a chunk more damage. We may have gone through the majority of the fighting, actually, and much of the waiting there was unnecessary. But still, I'm glad that I did it, because I'm a lot more confident now about going through this. And also gave me a little bit more of an idea of the time investment involved in building up a lot of healing items, like cheese, like bread. Let's see if I can't draw you over here. Wow, that does a fair old bit of damage, even to these level 4s. I'm actually pretty pleased with that. Oh, there's plenty more on the other sides. Okay. Let's see if I can't hit you with that. No. A little bit too far away, but I would really prefer to draw you by yourself rather than deal with the bear as well. There we go. Let's have a fight over here instead. No, no, come back. Come back, you. Ha-ha! Gotcha. Arrow in the back, as you deserve. Yes, scallywag, you. Okay, you're going to be a bit of a pest, though, aren't you? Yes, yes, you are. So I'm going to gobble down a piece of bread straight away so that we've got health regen throughout this fight. Even still, took us a fair bit of time to kill that bear. There's one or two goblins remaining. Let's eat some cheese at this point. You know, bread and cheese. And see what we can do about dealing with you without having to deal with both of you at the same time. Oh, no. Apparently, you both just want to fight at the same time regardless. There we go. Never mind. Thank you very much, arrows. You are lifesavers. And no. No, absolutely not. Is that going to even hit? No, it's not. Apparently, my absolutely not counts for nothing in this game. Okay. Well, this is a force of nature shot. Have I got to mine it or something? Maybe I've got to mine it. I'm going to guess I've got to mine it. Let's go ahead, equip this, and see what we can do then. Of course, you know, I could eat one of my breads instead, because I'm a bit of an idiot, really. Right, there we go. Let's see what we can do. So, I guess because it's mined in here, you can't just run in, grab it, and leave, and then be like, oh, well, even if I die, I don't really care too much. I meant to drink some coffee instead. I ate strawberry. Frankly, I feel that strawberry should replenish my stamina as well. There we go. Is this even what I'm meant to be doing? I have no idea how I'm meant to gather this force of nature shard. I'm just guessing that I've got it. There we go. Okay, find a piece of force of nature. Wow, look at the things on the floor. Gold ingot. Very nice. Some gold coins. Amethyst chip. Ruby chip. Force of nature shard and gold ingot. That was very much worth our time. My goodness. Okay, well, with that, then, we've completed a quest. And let's head back to our camp and then have a look at the state of our quests in general. I really like these little lamps. They are actually pretty damn cool, if you ask me. Right. Let's go back to the ominous thrumming of our portal. There we are. Nature's Den to Aavakus Prime, please. And there we go. Perfect. Right, let's have a quick look at our quest, then. Oh, we're up to get new level. Fair enough. And what do we need for level 7, then? That would be a nice place to end all of this on. We need 10 claws. Well, I only need a couple more. I may even have some lying around. I need 5 gold ingots and 10 pelts. Not so sure about that one. That may be a little bit more effort than I'm willing to invest. I've got loads of pelts, actually. The force of nature shard. This cannot be lost on death, which is, you know, pretty good to know, I suppose. But we need a lot more claws, and the claws seem to come from bears. Let's have a quick glance. How much? We'd need also a lot of gold. We do not have nearly enough gold to get that, because it costs a fair number of gold coins to get each one. So yeah, with that, I think we're going to wrap up this first taste. In total, this last episode has cost, well, cost makes it sound overdramatic. It has taken me about 2 hours and 20 minutes to record all of this with the time lapses and the downtime in between cuts. So yes, the grind is starting to ramp up considerably at this point. But I would temper that knowledge with the knowledge that quite a lot of the grind, especially the combat grind, it's actually quite fun. I really enjoyed it. The time seemed to pass much faster than I was aware of for the most part. And I'm really, really liking the way that my little camp is building up. I may continue this game as perhaps a bit of a stream game. I might play it on my Twitch stream now and then if people are interested. But that will be the end of this for the channel as a whole. I hope you've enjoyed, and I hope that this First Taste miniseries has given you the information that you need to make an educated decision on whether this is a game for you or not. But that is going to be the end of the episode from me. So as ever, remember to like if you liked, sub if you haven't, and I will see you in the next game that I First Taste. But until then, do take care.